Hello, everybody. This is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. How's everybody doing? Oh, I didn't hear you that time. How is everybody doing? All right, I heard you that time. We are moved by your love and your generosity. We are honored and thrilled that you guys are supporting this ministry. Because as the Bible declares, the Lord is our light and our salvation. We fear no one. God is the strength of our lives, and we fear no one. Listen, it's good to be with you all. Thank you all from the bottom of my heart to all of our faithful listeners that tune in each week to our Full of Life Ministries. We are overwhelmed at the response to this weekly platform called podcasting. We want to acknowledge and welcome our new listeners to this ministry in Iran and South Korea. Isn't it amazing just within a year how God continues to pour out his weekly dose of blessings upon his people? Again, if you are enjoying these episodes, please, please continue to share these episodes from Full of Life Ministries. We also have a YouTube page that renders services each Sunday at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And it's a brief service that provides God's message of hope. And we believe we'll continue to reach an audience that's looking for God's light to shine and to radiate the hearts of those who are searching for the answer, for the answers that will change their lives. And the answer is in Jesus Christ. And though we live in a perverse and cruel world, even when individuals continue to act out in a way that goes against the principles of morality, and their refusal to acquiesce and conduct themselves in a civilized manner, we have to remember the teachings that God's word provides for us, and to know that God is the giver of life, and that his light gives us the opportunities to enjoy life. You see, we have to remain true to God and know that he has our back. Help me say that God's got my back. Can you say that a little bit louder? God's got my back. Yes, he does. Because there's a passage of scripture that reminds us just how God has us covered. It's found in Psalms 36. And it reads, "Sin speaks in the depths of the soul of those who oppose God. They listen closely to his urgings. You'll never see the fear of God in their eyes, for they flatter themselves, convinced their sin will remain secret, undiscovered, and so unhated. They speak words of evil and deceit. Wisdom and goodness they deserted long ago. Even as they sleep, believe it or not, they are plotting mischief. They journey along a path far from anything good, gravitating to trouble, welcoming evil. Your love, O God, towers high into the heavens. Even the skies are lower than your faithfulness. Your justice is like the majestic mountains. Your judgments are as deep as the oceans. And yet in your greatness, you, O God, offer life for every person and even the animals. Your strong love, O true God, is precious. All people run for shelter under the shadow of your wings, because in your house they eat and are full at your table. They drink from the river of your overflowing kindness. You have the fountain of life that quenches our thirst. Your light has opened our eyes and awakened our souls. May your love continue to grow deeply in the lives of all who know you. May your salvation reach every heart committed to do right. Give me shelter from prideful feet that hunt me down and wicked hands that push me from your path. It is there, far away from you, that the wicked will be forced down, face to the earth, never again returning to their feet. People of God, what this passage is saying to us this day is that we have to understand that life begins and ends through God. The entrance of His word gives us light and life, and we have to embrace His goodness for our lives, because His fountain of life is the only thing that will quench our thirst. God provides for us satisfaction. His fountain provides peace to our soul. His fountain gives us endurance to run a race that appears at times to be daunting and unachievable. His fountain of life neutralizes the temptations that try to undercut and to undermine our character and integrity. His fountain of grace provides for us unmerited favor beyond what we deserve. His fountain of salvation liberates us by breaking the chains of death and paving a way to receive eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. But we have to guard ourselves from prideful feet. We have to pray to the Father to protect us from people who will try to force you to retreat from God's standards by wooing you away from God's teachings. For there is a path that we have to walk. There is a path that we have to walk. And just like St. Matthew chapter 7, verses 13 and 14 says that we are to walk on the narrow path. We have to walk on the narrow path, people of God. And this narrow way means making an absolute and total commitment to Jesus Christ. It means loving on Him, obeying Him, depending on Him, worshiping Him, giving ourselves to Him. Because a wide path is very broad, and this wide path is very easy. And the wide path, a lot of people are walking on this wide path. But the wide path, the broad, easy, crowded path leads to death. That's the sad part, that the enemy never shows you the end result by you walking on this wide road, this wide path. But the person who walks on the narrow path, this leads to life. Because it's hard to find that road sometimes, because not many people manage it. Walking on this narrow path will provide for you. It will give you the strength that you need in order not to get weary in doing good for Jesus. Amen? Amen. All right, let's get into today or tonight's episode. And as always, the Lord has given us a word that I believe will resonate with every person who has ever wanted to make a difference in this world. We all have been given We've been given motivational speeches. We have been moved by motivational speakers challenging us to use the gifts that's inside of all of us. But yet we continue to get bogged down by the cares of life. We've allowed our fears to control our minds, having us give up on any chance that by demonstrating God's gift that He's given you, that will ultimately will result in an epic failure, resulting in you wandering around in life because you've lost your passion, you've lost your zeal, and you've even lost your purpose, and you are wondering, can you ever get it back? Well, my friends, the Lord has some good news for you. Yes, you can get it back. You know why? Because God always catches us when we become frail and weak, when we lose our spiritual circulation, when we become lightheaded when it comes to the things that God has promised us. And even when you have lost your courage in facing something that appears too hard to handle, God wants to invigorate your spirit with a faith that says that I can do all things through Christ that will always give me the strength to make it in this life. And so today or tonight's episode is tailor-made to get rid of these spiritual fainting spells that we have. And guess what the title of today or tonight's episode is? Yes, the title of today or tonight's episode is entitled Spiritual Fainting Spells. Spiritual Fainting Spells. You know, losing your nerves when the pressures of life create so many scenarios that you begin doubting if God is going to come through for you. You may be suffering from a spiritual fainting spell, or because your mountain appears too difficult to climb, you're ready to quit, and you give up on the plans that God has shown you. You may be experiencing a spiritual fainting spell. There are several things that cause us to faint. Handling the pressures of life, that will cause a fainting spell, a spiritual fainting spell. Your personal struggles with sin. You know, there are times when sin speaks to you, saying, give up, throw in the towel. Because the enemy's job is to make you feel unworthy. That's his job, to make you feel unworthy. His job is to bring shame into your life, for you to walk around in condemnation. And this condemnation changes your attitude, making you bitter. Sometimes we forget the encouraging words that God's word has said about us. We forget what God has said in His word about our lives. That you are fearfully and wonderfully made. That you are a chosen generation. You are His masterpiece. You are His child. That we are a friend of God's. We forget what God has said about us. And this will cause you to faint. Lacking a consistent prayer life. Ooh, that's a big one. You feel like you're not making significant progress in your Christian walk because you compare yourself to others. Think about all of these things that will cause a person to faint. You are spiritually malnourished. You are spiritually malnourished Because this is a big one. Because anytime you become weak, you are more vulnerable to a fainting spell, a spiritual fainting spell. Not willing to be corrected. We hate to be told what to do. That's the sad part. You see, people of God, growth is so important. And when you refuse instruction because you believe you don't need to be taught, you are more susceptible to a spiritual fainting spell. And lastly, focusing on the problem rather than believing in the goodness that only God will bring. This will cause you to faint and become weary. Now, there's more than I could talk to you about these spiritual fainting spells. Time won't allow us to go deeper into this. But you know what's causing you to faint. We all have set ourselves up for spiritual fainting spells. Now listen, before we could go on to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we are going to give you important tools to strengthen yourselves to walk in the authority of God and significantly reduce these spiritual fainting spells. So people of God, don't you go nowhere. We'll be right back with the episode entitled Spiritual Fainting Spells.
Hi, everyone. I'm Christopher. I'm the editor of Full of Life Ministry San Diego podcast. And I'm here to say if you like what you're hearing and would like to donate, you definitely can. On any of our pages, on our Instagram, on our Spotify, Spreaker, all of that, there should be a button that allows you to donate to our ministry. With your donations, we're able to donate to a variety of different things, COVID relief or anyone who just may need it in general. That's all for me, so thank you guys for listening and enjoy the rest of the podcast.
All right, we are back. We are back. And so let's discover the best way to prevent spiritual fainting spells. Are you ready? All right. Now listen, in order to prevent these spiritual fainting spells, number one, always follow Jesus' example. I'm going to say that one more time. Always follow Jesus' example. Hebrews, the 12th chapter and the 3rd verse, God's word says, consider the life of the one who endured such personal attacks and hostility from sinners, so that you will not grow weary or lose heart. The pressures of life, the personal attacks, the hostility that life throws your way. We have the greatest example that if we allow Christ to rule our hearts with the strength Jesus provides for us, we will never grow weary or lose heart. Yes, growing weary is an oxymoron phrase. Growing weary and losing heart are indicators that our faith is not where it's supposed to be. When you consider his life, think about Jesus' life. And if Jesus can sustain through the attacks and hostility, we too can win in life just like Jesus won. Thanks be to God who causes us to triumph in Christ. Jesus won the battle, and we can win the battle against becoming spiritually faint. So always, if you're looking for a hero, look to Jesus. Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. So number one, always follow Jesus' example. Number two, you have to. Now listen, people of God, you have to encourage yourself in God. You have to. Now, in 1 Samuel, the 30th chapter, in the 6th verse, it says, this is Brother David. David was greatly distressed, for the people spoke of stoning him, because all the people were bitter in soul, each for his sons and daughters. But David strengthened himself in the Lord, his God. So when you encourage yourself over things that try to defeat you, your response in faith allows you to get up and to face the difficulties that life brings your way. Sometimes you can send a text to somebody and they may not give you that encouraging word. You could talk to family, and sometimes family is not available to you to encourage yourself. And sometimes you can go to work and you look for somebody to give you an encouraging word, and sometimes it does not come. But when you take the moment to encourage yourself, to tell yourself to get up, and that you are a child of God, and that if you believe in God's word and his promises for your life, you will get over these spiritual fainting spells, because the enemy brings these things to try to create weakness and to bring doubt and fear into one's life. But when you encourage yourself to understand who you are, then the enemy has to leave the premises. So number two, encourage yourself, not in yourself, but encourage yourself in God. Number three, feed yourself with the right nutrients. I want to say that one more time. Feed yourself with the right nutrients. Psalms 1, verses 1 through 3 says, God's blessings follow you and await you at every turn when you don't follow the advice of those who delight in wicked schemes. Ah, there is the weakness. When you avoid sin's highway, there you go. That's another one. Spiritual fainting spells. When judgment and sarcasm beckon you, but you refuse. For you, the God's word is your happiness. The God's word is your happiness. It is your focus. From dust to dawn, you are like a tree planted by flowing, cool streams of water that never runs dry. Your fruit ripens in its time. Your leaves never fade or curl in the summer sun. No matter what you do, you prosper. Plant yourself in God's refreshing rivers of life. And these rivers never, ever run dry. When we are not feeding ourselves with the right substance, which is God's word, we spiritually dehydrate ourselves, which will cause us to faint. Remaining to God's word produces fruit. So I want to go back to that. Listen, it says that we become spiritually dehydrated because we lack God's word in our lives. But when we remain in God's word produces the fruit that we need. And this fruit is a ripe fruit. A fruit that will help others become spiritually healthy and whole. Fading leaves is the indicator that you are about to faint. Curling up when the heat of life begins to sap you of the energy that God can give you to endure various tests. So James 1 says, happy is the person who can hold up under the trials of life. At the right time, he'll know God's sweet approval and will be crowned with life. as God has promised, the crown awaits all who love him. And Galatians, the 6th chapter, the 9th verse says, may we never tire of doing what is good and right. Before our Lord, because in his season we shall bring in a great harvest if we can just persist. That's what it has to do with feeding ourselves with the right nutrients. So number 4, embrace God's instructions for your life. Embrace God's instructions for your life. Proverbs, the 3rd chapter, verses 11 and 12 says, do not ignore God's instructions or lose heart when he steps in to correct you, because God proves his love by caring enough to discipline you, just as the father does his child, his pride and joy. Isn't that amazing? Do not ignore God's instruction for your life, because if you ignore it, you're going to lose heart. You're going to become spiritually faint when you ignored God's instructions, because God proves his love by caring enough to discipline you. He loves you so much that he will not allow for you to continue to operate in a weak state of mind. So embrace God's instructions for your life. That's number 4. And number 5, look forward to God's goodness. Look forward to God's goodness. Psalms 27 and 13 says, I will move past my enemies with this one sure hope that with my own eyes, I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I love this. Move past your enemies, people of God, because this is a sure hope that you're going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Moving past your haters is the best thing, not to fall victim to fainting. Letting go of past issues, letting go of past hurts, releasing the pain that your enemies have created in your life, and looking forward to realizing what the Lord has in store for you will keep you in perfect peace and make the enemy leave your internal space that's set up for God to reside. This is the good news. Look forward to what God has in store for you. And so in closing, spiritual fainting spells are designed to bring an unnecessary fear to your life. And when you develop a strong prayer life, coupled with a faith in God to succeed in life, and studying God's word so you can always understand when those weaknesses come into your life, when you operate in these aspects of life, hear me, people of God, the fainting spells will go away from your life forever, because now you are operating as a person who is in tune, entangled, and strengthened by God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all of your many blessings. We thank you for speaking to our hearts. We thank you for understanding our shortcomings. You are God, and beside you there is no other. Lord God, you know what makes us weak. You know what makes us frail. Sometimes we use the wrong ingredients in order to try to find happiness. We're looking for love in all the wrong places. We're trying to find satisfaction through drugs and alcohol. We want to fit in somewhere instead of fitting into what you have in store for us. So Lord God, I ask you in the name that's above every name, in the name of Jesus, that you will minister to our hearts, that you will just love on us and prevent these spiritual fainting spells to happen in our lives. We want to be strong. We want to walk in your authority. We want the enemy to flee our premise, which is in our heart and our mind. So Lord God, help us to overcome these temptations, these shortcomings, the lack of information, us getting entangled in sin. Free us right now so we can live a life that's pleasing in your eyes. We'll be careful to give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. We ask all these blessings in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, people of God, that is it for today or tonight's episode entitled Spiritual Fainting Spells. This is Pastor Phil, the one and the only Pastor Phil of Full of Life Ministries. We appreciate you guys listening for this podcast. I believe God has spoken to us, and I pray that you will apply these teachings to your life, because this message of hope is designed to empower you, to inspire you, to uplift you, and to encourage you to live a full and meaningful life. And that's what this ministry is, Full of Life Ministries San Diego. Thank you guys for tuning in each week. If you're enjoying the podcast, again, please share the podcast. The Lord is truly moving in a mighty way. Sunday mornings, 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, Full of Life Ministries are now on YouTube. So please check us out, support us. We appreciate what you're doing, and God is doing some great things and greatly to be praised, because God is doing what he designed for this podcast to do, is to make a difference in people's life. Once again, this is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. If there's anything that we can do to help you along your Christian journey, don't hesitate. Don't hesitate to email us at fullofLifeSD@gmail.com. Once again, I'm going to say that one more time. fullofLifeSD@gmail.com. We are here to serve you. We are here to help you grow, to become the man and woman that God has created you to be. If you feel led to support us financially, please go to any of our platforms to sow into our ministry. God wants to do great things within this world that we're living in. We want to be difference makers. So just be prayerful about whatever the amount that the Lord has placed on your heart to sow into this ministry. You could go to any of the platforms, Spotify, Google, Anchor, Spreaker, whatever the platform that you listen to on this podcast. Please be prayerful. Give what the Lord has placed on your heart. We also have a Cash App, Full of Life SD, that you can sow into this ministry. Whatever way that you want to bless us, we will be blessed with whatever amount that you sow into this ministry. This is Pastor Phil with Full of Life Ministries. Thank you guys for tuning in. Share the podcast, and let's continue to do this in Jesus' name. God bless.